Motion is an integral part of our daily life. From Usain Bolt's phenomenal sprint to a feet-dragging ghost coming out from the TV. In another video, we learned that motion has many types. They can be visualized using graphs that depict changes in quantities related to the movement. One such graph is a distance-time graph. The distance-time graph visualizes the distance traveled, d, by an object over time, t, which are represented by the vertical and horizontal axis respectively. To illustrate linear motion, let's consider the example of a car moving at a constant speed. Imagine you and your child are on a trip, but your child won't stop crying due to hunger. As the car is about to pass the police patrol, you maintain a humble speed of just 4 meters per second. How do you picture the car movement on the graph? Remember that constant speed means you cover the same distance per unit time, in this case per second. Here, the distance you reach each second is 4 meters. If we choose the police patrol as the reference point, where the distance, d, is 0, then after 1 second, the car has moved 4 meters away from the police. The next second car is 8 meters from the police patrol, and so on. In the graph, this data is shown as small dots at the intersection of the distance and time axes. As you see, the graph slopes up, indicating the increase of distance. The slope or gradient of the graph implies the value of speed. Why? It's because the rise over the run of the slope represents distance over time, which is equal to the speed formula. A steeper slope indicates a higher speed because more distance is covered per unit time. Conversely, a shallow gradient indicates a slower speed. Since the upward slope shows that you move forward, now you can tell what a downward sloping line indicates. The decreasing distance over time means you're moving backward, approaching the point of reference. However, it is still a straight line, so the speed remains constant for that time interval, despite being negative due to the change of direction. So does it mean that speeds can change over time? Absolutely! In fact, it happens all the time in real life. A moving object that changes speed experiences either an acceleration or deceleration. For instance, if you accelerate at a constant rate of 2 meters per second squared, then its speed increases by 2 meters per second every second during acceleration. This makes the distance rise exponentially, hence form a curve. The similar graph also appears when you're plotting a free-falling object, whose motion is affected by gravitational acceleration, g, of 9.8 meters per second squared. The speed is 9.8 meters per second squared faster than before every second, making the curve steeper. Since the speed is always changing, we're only able to calculate instantaneous speed. Now, how to visualize the car motion when you stop the car? The car is not moving at all, so the graph is depicted as a horizontal line for a whole second. Now, look at this graph. Can you tell the object speed of every section? Share your answers in the comments below. Thank you for your continuous support, especially our valued patrons and members who have been encouraging us to keep producing more quality content.